Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to SLAM. Today, we continue with week three of our series, United We Stand. We are being reminded that as faithful citizens, our first allegiance is to Jesus, and everything in our lives must flow from that, from our purpose to our relationships with other people. Everything starts with Jesus. The gospel story we heard today gives us a really important message about all of this. So let's dive right in. Take a minute and think about these questions. Is it better to be first or last? When is it better to be first? Is there a time when it's better to be last? Take a minute and just think about those questions. Think about what that means. Sometimes our assumptions and our judgments are far from our values from God. Sometimes our society overemphasizes the importance of being first or being number one. But there are times when the ordering of things might be better in the reverse. And today's gospel asks us to reconsider our values and make our judgments more than appearances. So in our gospel, the mistake that the workers make is that they believe they had and were entitled to something more than what had been negotiated. It's the workers who are being unfair. They're seeking to change the terms of what they agreed upon. They want to change the deal. The landowner in the parable realizes that they're jealous because he's generous. They cannot be thankful for the payment they received and the opportunity to work at all. Sometimes it's like this between God and us. We forget that God's love for us is given to us freely and generously. We haven't earned it. God owes us nothing, but he offers us his love abundantly. He offers us his love abundantly. That means he wants us to have it. He loves us more than anything in the world, and all he wants us to do is to accept that love. And it's our choice. Jesus tells us that the last will be first and the first will be last. He teaches us that God loves each of us, each one of us, individually. He gives us his love freely and generously. And when we spend time thinking that we deserve more than what we have, it's as though we have our heads in our hands like this, and we're blocking our vision from God. We're saying, oh, I hear what he's saying, but I'm choosing not to listen to it. I'm choosing not to accept his free and generous love. We can't see and appreciate the wonderful gifts God gives us if we're not open to it. We miss out on having a grateful and generous heart. So this week, let's all make time to notice and be more grateful for the many gifts that God has given us, for our family and our friends, our schools, our parents. Let's take that time, have a grateful heart, and be open to God's free and generous love. Have a great week, boys and girls, and I'll see you next time. Bye.